In the previous class, we discussed about the meaning of an insurance policy and its principles. Today, we shall first study about the types of insurance. The types of insurance is presented in the form of a table on page 13 of your textbook. But we shall study only the types of life insurance corporation and general insurance corporation and the names of the other types of general insurance. Let us start with life insurance. One who is born is sure to die. It is much uncertain when will death approach. Income ceases on the death of an individual. The dependents become helpless. Keeping this fact in mind, even after death, that the heirs get financial support, the individual takes life insurance. Life insurance means the insurance company promises to pay the fixed amount of insurance to the heirs of the deceased who have taken insurance. Such contract is called insurance of life. Life insurance is divided into two types. One is whole life insurance and endowment insurance. In the whole life insurance, the insurance company promises to pay the fixed amount to the heirs. Heirs means dependents of the deceased who have taken insurance, and such contract is called insurance of whole life. For this, the insured has to pay fixed premium to the insurance company. The premium is paid at fixed interval to the life insurance company. Individual's life is valuable. It is priceless. As per life insurance contract, if natural death occurs and there is no reason to suspect death, then insurance company pays full amount to the dependent of the deceased. The principle of indemnity is not applied to life insurance. It is applied only to articles because life is precious and hence there cannot be any price decided for it. The next insurance is endowment insurance. The contract in which insurance company promises to pay the amount on maturity to the insuree or to their heirs in case of death before maturity of policy is called endowment insurance. Under this type of contract, insuree has to pay fixed amount as a premium at fixed time to the insurance company. In the current time, out of two types of life insurance policy, endowment policy has become more popular. Now, let us see the goods transportation insurance, which comes under the types of general insurance. General insurance. Many types of risks are associated with assets and property. Damage to property and agriculture is caused by fire, accident, cyclone, earthquake, tsunami, and other natural calamities. General insurance is a common concept to get compensation against economic loss. Meaning of general insurance. The asset of which physical values exist and compensation due to specific causes of loss is paid by insurance company within specific calculation is called general insurance contract. There are three types of general insurance: goods transportation insurance, marine insurance, and aviation insurance. Let us see the goods transportation insurance. Partial or total risk of damage to the goods may occur when they are taken from one place to the other. As against this, three types of insurance is available. They are marine insurance, aviation insurance, road or railway insurance. Marine insurance is called as insurance which is taken when goods are taken through the sea. Marine insurance was initiated in the 18th century by Lloyd's of London. On the marine route, the risk of robbery through sea robbers, tsunami are faced. Against damage done to get economic protection, the insurance of ship and the goods is taken. Lloyd's of London was the first to start marine insurance. This company has maintained its image of loyalty for more than 325 years. Air insurance is also called as aviation insurance. With the beginning of 19th century, the movement of goods through air commenced, which led to the beginning of air insurance. Air insurance is costly and risky, hence highly valuable and lightweight goods are transported by air. The premium for air insurance is higher than marine and railroad insurance. The next type of insurance is rail and road insurance. Transportation of goods is carried out through road and railway route. During transportation through these two routes, there is economic risk caused by theft, robbery, and accident. Insurance which is taken to get compensation against loss is called as railroad insurance. Fire insurance. The insurance taken of specific property or goods, and if it is totally or partially damaged or completely destroyed by fire, then the insurance company has promised to pay compensation is called contract of fire insurance. The other types of general insurance are insurance of hand, foot and fingers of cricketer, insurance of throat of a singer, third party damage or loss in insurance, insurance for students, fraud committed by employee, etc. Mediclaim or medical insurance is a recent development. Mediclaim or medical insurance is to compensate for the huge medical expenses incurred by a person in the event of any health problem against a periodical premium paid by an insurer to the insurance company. Our next topic is privatization of insurance. Insurance was first started by the private sector in India. As India was under the British rule, many foreign insurance companies started insurance business in India. As they were practicing a lot of malpractices, on 19 January 1956, through an ordinance, life insurance business was nationalized and the Life Insurance Corporation of India was set up. Thus, the monopoly of Life Insurance Corporation was established. General insurance was introduced by Britishers in India. On 1st January 1973, the general insurance business was nationalized on the basis of General Insurance Act of 1972. To analyze and appraise the working of insurance sector, a committee was appointed. It recommended the joint business by foreign insurance company with Indian counterparts. Therefore, Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority was set up in 1999 to support it. Let us now understand about Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India. This is a supreme and autonomous and legal institution which manages the regulatory and development activities in the field of insurance. IRDA Act of 1999 has opened the doors of insurance to private insurance companies and to foreign insurance companies to the extent of 26%, which was raised to 49% in 2015. The main objectives of IRDA are policyholders must get more choice, promote healthy competition among the various insurance companies, which can improve the services with lower premium, mobilize more resources for the economy, to bring self-discipline among the insurance companies, and to create a mechanism for complaint and redressing. After the insurance services, now let us understand about the postal services. Postal services play an important role in written information and communication. It is essential to pass on information from one place to another speedily and without any interruption. The Indian Postal Department has been providing information and communication services for more than 150 years. The Postal Department is providing services other than just postal services like money order, acceptance of various forms of deposits through small savings plan, postal life insurance and rural insurance scheme. It also provides services of paying retirement pension. India has got 150,000 post offices, out of which 90% are set up in rural areas. Let us understand the services provided by the Postal Department. General posts and letters. Information and communication can be sent through postcard, inland letters, covers, etc. Registered post. Postal department provides services of registered post. Such posts are delivered by postal department, for which the charges are more than general postal communication. If the sender of the post requires a proof in the form of signature of the receiver, some extra charges have to be paid. Parcel services. All products other than those prohibited by law can be sent in the form of parcel from one place to the other. Booking of parcel can be done from any post office. Generally, the sender of the parcel pays fees to the post office. Value payable post. In parcel service, value payable post is more popular. Any producer or seller on receiving an order for a product sends a parcel to the postal department, and the receiver of the parcel pays the parcel charges and the price which is pre-decided to the postal department, which in turn is passed to the sender. Speed post. The postal department guarantees to deliver the post parcel within a stipulated time. It can be insured if required. The charges are higher for speed post than the general post parcel. Express parcel. This service is available for both individuals and business units. Express parcel is sent very speedily within the prescribed time limit. The fees for this is higher than the speed post. Let us see the saving services of the postal department. Postal department, just like the banks, provide various types of saving schemes like savings account, 5-year recurring account, term deposits, monthly income plan, senior citizen savings certificate, 15 years public provident fund, 5 to 10 years Kisan Vikas Patra, Sukanya Samruddhi account, etc. Just like the bank, post office savings can also be opened, for which checkbook is given, and now there is facility of ATM card. Recurring deposit. According to the scheme, the account holder has to pay the amount as decided on or before the pre-decided date to the post office. At the end of 5 years, when the account matures, the entire principal amount along with interest will be received by the account holder. Term deposit. Term deposit is like fixed deposit schemes available in post office. As per the scheme, accounts can be opened for duration of 1, 2, 3 or 5 years or for 200 rupees in its multiples. Interest is calculated and is done every 3 months, but the amount of interest is paid on an yearly basis. National Savings Certificate. Those who want to invest in NSE will have to purchase it from post office. The duration of this saving scheme is 5 to 10 years. It is included in the income tax deduction. The information of interest rate is given in advance. At the end of maturity period of 5 to 10 years, amounts can be claimed by fulfilling the required formalities from the post office. Kisan Vikas Patra. The depositor in Kisan Vikas Patra gets double the invested amount after 100 months, that is 8 years and 4 months. Public Provident Fund. Any individual can open an account in Public Provident Fund scheme. The period duration of this account is 15 years. The minimum amount to be paid in this account is 500 per annum. After 15 years, under the prevailing rules, the account can be extended by 5 years every time. This is exempted from income tax calculation. The account cannot be closed before 15 years. Postal insurance. Prior to independence of India, as part of welfare scheme, postal insurance was started. All the employees of central government, state government and semi-government organizations are available for this insurance. The salient features of postal insurance are lowest premium and maximum bonus. Monthly income scheme. Under this scheme, individual or joint accounts can be opened. The accounts can be opened for a period of 5 years. Money order. Money order is an arrangement to send money from one place to the other through post office. For this service, post office charges commission. There are two types of money order, instant money order and e-money order. Post office has started instant money order by using online technology through which amount to the extent of 1000 to 50,000 can be sent to any part of India within a day. When the sender reaches the post office and after paying money in commission, a secret number in a sealed envelope is given to him. The sender gives that secret number to the receiver. When the receiver presents the photo ID and secret number, he can receive money from the designated post office. Recently, the post office has started e-money order. Through e-money order, money can be received by the receiver the next day at his address. Rupees 1 to 5,000 can be sent through e-money order. The sender should fill up his name, address, PIN code of the receiver. Within 24 hours, money is paid to the receiver at his address. Along with money, if needed, one message out of pre-decided messages can be sent to the receiver. The other related services of postal department are services like purchase and sale of foreign currency, traveler's check in foreign currency, debit card in foreign currency, draft in foreign currency, mutual fund investment agency, services for various schemes of Government of India, railway ticket booking, etc. People have great faith in the postal department as it is under the direct ownership of Government of India. Our next topic is godown or warehouse. A place for storing the goods is called as warehouse. After production, every product cannot be immediately sold or consumed and hence storage becomes essential. Godown is necessary for preserving the perishable goods. Some goods only have seasonal demand, but its production takes place throughout the year. Such goods are stored in godown, and when there is a demand, it will be supplied from the godown. On many occasions, materials are essential to be stored for production, for inventory management as part of commerce, and godown services essential. Warehousing is not only concerned with storage facilities but is also involved in various other activities like receiving, identifying, holding, assembling and preparing to meet the demand. According to Robert Hughes, warehousing is a set of activities that are involved in receiving and storing of goods and preparing them for reshipment. I request you to go through the slide and understand the functions of the warehouse. The first function of the warehouse is receiving goods. A warehouse accepts the merchandise delivered by the transporter and then accepts the responsibility for the merchandise. The second function is identifying goods. The appropriate stock keeping units are identified and a record is made of the number of each item received. Sorting goods. The incoming goods are sorted out for the appropriate storage area in the warehouse. Dispatching goods to the storage. When the goods are kept aside, they can be found later when needed. Holding goods. The goods are kept in the storage under proper protection until needed in the warehouse. Let us now understand the types of godown. The types of godown are represented in the form of a chart in page number 17 of your textbook. Kindly go through. Let us now understand the types of godown from ownership perspective. Private godown. Any trader or manufacturer who owns a godown for storage of his personal goods is called as private warehouse. Public godown. The godown which is owned not for storing goods for his own business but for public use is called as public godown. Public godowns are situated near railway stations, ports and airport. Today, public godowns have developed as an independent profession. Public godowns provide receipts for the products which have been accepted by them for storage. The receipts are transferable and so while the product is in public godown, there can be purchase and sale of such products. The next classification is classification of godowns from perspective of custom duty. Godowns for product whose custom duty is paid. Imported goods for which custom duty has been paid but there is no availability of transport facilities to transport them to their destination are stored in public godowns near seaports, airports and border areas. Such godowns are known as godowns for product whose custom duty is paid. Bonded godown. Custom duty will have to be paid on import if such goods for which duty has not been paid are stored in the godown. Such godowns are called as bonded godowns. Such godowns are located near places of import like ports, borders of country, etc. Our next classification is godowns based on usefulness perspective. One is general godown. Those goods for which no special care or specific maintenance or treatment is required, and when such goods are stored in godowns, such godowns are general godowns. All products of different shapes, weight, volume, nature, etc. are stored in godowns which are widespread. Specific godowns. Those products which require special care, treatment, maintenance, and godowns which store such products are specific godowns. Such specific godowns become important for products like crackers, explosives, petroleum, poisonous chemicals, cooking gas, etc. The specific godowns are underground tanks for petroleum products and special types of bricks for poisonous chemicals, for perishable items like fruits, milk, vegetables, etc. Cold storage is essential. Different laws are to be followed for safety purpose. Specific godowns are expensive. With this, we come to the end of the topic of warehouses or godowns.